going. Welcome, everyone, to the road to the new Mutants! Woo! We have today my good friend, Mr. Mark L. How you doing, M.T.S. the Shark?
What's up, everybody?
Yes, he doesn't talk about movies much anymore, but today we decided... What?
I would talk about movies if the virus didn't kill them.
Well, you talked about Tenet a week ago?
Yeah, which is what I plan to do when a movie I'm actually pretty interested in comes out. I haven't seen New Mutants yet.
Well, maybe you can review Devil All the Time with Tom Holland. That's on Netflix right now.
I'll probably watch it. I'm not sure if I'll make a full review, but I'll probably watch it.
Yeah, it's a pretty big Netflix movie right now. Trying to think. I watched part of your Tenet review. I didn't finish it, but it seems like you weren't that excited about it.
I really liked it. I thought it was a great movie. My only thing with it, though, was I just wasn't as good as other Nolan movies. I expected...
Yeah, that's how I felt about Dunkirk, yeah.
I don't even think Dunkirk is one of his best. I don't think Dunkirk's on the level of, like, Interstellar.
Nah, not at all. Or Inception, of course, The Dark Knight, my favorite. But
yeah. Dark Knight's everyone's favorite.
Actually, some people say Inception's better, which I can understand that viewpoint, but I just prefer Dark Knight. I mean,
I guess Inception has a little more of a heart to it.
Well, Inception's more original, I guess. Dark Knight's based on something else, I mean...
Inception's, like, one of the most original movies I've ever seen.
It's pretty amazing. I saw Inception in the theater. That was an amazing theater experience, but...
It came out way too early for me to see it in the theater. I was fine.
Well, they re-released it. You could have saw it in the theater, but...
Oh, yeah, I did hear about that. I didn't go...
Okay, enough about Nolan stuff, okay? We gotta talk about X-Men Apocalypse, so...
Apocalypse is from 2016. And it was the first time I looked at the trailer for an X-Men movie. I remember when the trailer dropped.
I saw that trailer. That was awesome.
And I was like, oh my god, this looks so cool. And I remember that, like, I remember hyping this so much.
Everybody was hyped for X-Men Apocalypse. Now, unfortunately, it's a very mixed movie. A lot of people hate it. A lot of people love it. I'm on the love it side, but, you know. I mean,
I'm not going to go out and say I love it, but I really enjoy it.
I'll get into details why I love the movie so much. The people that are watching this confused, they're like, what the fuck, Tate, what? But I'm going to explain, just give me a sec. So, well, Mark, what do you think about the movie? What do you like about it?
I like it. I'll start with my issues with it. First, I don't really love the villain.
You don't like Apocalypse? I love Apocalypse, but...
I don't think it's really as good as some of the other main X-Men movies. But I do really enjoy it, and I think it's really well put together. There's a lot of actually really cool emotional points to it. It's very entertaining, and I think it works really well as kind of a semi... It's like a sequel to Days of Future Past, but it's also like a prequel to it as well.
Yeah.
I think it handled that well. Even though it isn't half as good as Days of Future Past, I still think it's a fun movie. And it's enjoyable every time I see it. So.
You know, yeah. When I talk about the second trilogy X-Men movies for me are First Class, Days of Future Past, and this one, Apocalypse. And I feel...
Forget Dark Phoenix. We just don't.
Well, I'm not counting Dark Phoenix. That's a later review, but that'll be a funny movie review I do. But
I should have. You know what? I should have signed up to review Dark Phoenix, but it's fine.
I got Mondarino on that one, but. Yeah.
I will watch that, because that movie's one of the worst superhero films ever made.
I don't know about worst, but it definitely wasn't needed. It definitely wasn't needed.
I don't like anything about it. I don't think they did one good thing in the entire movie.
Okay, Mark, look, I still think X-Men Origins Wolverine's the worst movie, okay? I'm sorry.
War Origins is pretty terrible, but I'd give that like a 2 out of 10, and I'd give Dark Phoenix a 1. So.
God damn. I don't hate that. Okay, get back on topic, Apocalypse, so... So yeah, basically I equate this like the Dark Knight trilogy. First Class is like Batman Begins, Days of Future Past is like Dark Knight, and Apocalypse is like Dark Knight Rises. They all serve a purpose in this trilogy, and I feel Apocalypse did a very good job of being a last movie to this trilogy. Maybe some people don't agree with what they did, but I do think it's an excellent final movie. Not counting Dark Phoenix.
I've never really looked at that actually in the trilogy.
It really kind of is, because Apocalypse does a lot of full circle shit that First Class established. Right. I mean, he meets his wife again. He restores his memory. All the X-Men team up to fight Apocalypse at the end. They all unite as one team, which was never done before in any movie except for X2, I guess. But I mean, it was just so cool to see. And also, Angel isn't fodder like he was in Last Stand, where he's just a freaking throwaway character. He actually does something in the movie. It's actually kind of cool. But let me think what else. Of course, we can't talk about Apocalypse without talking about the best scene in the movie, which is Sweet Dreams with freaking Quicksilver.
God, what I loved about the Days of Future Past scene and just re-replicated it and did it really well.
I think really that it's scene. Still my favorite scene. And the final fight is amazing too, but that scene is still the best.
Actually, okay, there's a character, okay. You know, Magneto is the best character in X-Men, and I will stand by that. And this
well,
is
duh.
I think this is the movie that made me realize that.
Well, to be fair, is Magneto bad in any movie? It's like Wolverine. Not counting X-Men Origins, but I mean...
In Dark Phoenix, I felt like he had a pretty recycled arc.
Yeah, in Dark Phoenix, he was kind of filler. He didn't really do much.
But like another one of those I'm bad, but now I'm good arcs that he does in all the movies.
Well, to be fair, I mean, Dark Phoenix has his exclusive issues.
It's cool because it's like he gets this family, he gets all these like amazing things, and he's thrown right back in. It has a really nice emotional side to that.
Yeah.
In a movie that a lot of the time is dismissed for having zero emotion.
Hmm. All right. Well, yeah, the part where Magneto, he loses his family, that was pretty messed up, honestly.
Nina, no, please, please, please.
Ale coś ty zrobił.
That's a pretty powerful scene, actually.
And of course, when Apocalypse. Well, but the funniest part was when Apocalypse comes to the portal and Magneto looks at him like, who the fuck are you?
That's so funny. Yeah, that's a classic scene. I love that scene.
Bro, I had to pause the movie and I bawled out laughing when that happened. It was just like...
That's okay. This
that's kind of like a meme, I swear.
It's not really like a praise to the X-Men, but you know, every R-rated movie gets, or every PG-13 rated movie gets one F-bomb.
Yeah, they used it pretty good in that one.
They do it so well, like in First Class.
Yeah, in First Class too, he's like, get the fuck out or something.
Dude, he's like, yeah, they find Wolverine, and then they
fuck off. Yeah, that's.
They just quote what he said, and then in Apocalypse they do it again. But in Dark Phoenix, they ruined it. But
they had an F bomb in there. I didn't even realize that.
Yeah, no, it was like they're talking. There's a scene where they're like talking about going and killing Jean, and then Cyclops is like, if you go in there, if you try and kill her, I'll effing kill you. And I was like, that's a lame way to use your...
That was pretty lame. My favorite's Alita, when she said, I forget. She's fighting Grushka, and she's like, no fucking mercy or something. I don't know. Fuck your mercy, that's it. That was the best part, yeah.
Oh, yeah, that was badass, actually. That was good.
Of course, in Jojo Rabbit, where he's like, fuck you, Hitler, and he kicks him out of the window.
Yes.
Yeah, when PG-13 movies use the F-bomb pretty good, I really applaud that. Like,
if they do it right, they don't just play it at the beginning as just a normal F-bomb.
Nah.
See, this is what's cool about movies like Logan and Deadpool. They don't have to, you know, play off F-bombs.
Logan's my favorite, but I'm going to get into that with my best friend later, but that's the next movie. But
yeah.
Oh, speaking of Logan, I'm going to talk about why Apocalypse is important to the story and the overall narrative and why it leads into Logan, so... One thing Apocalypse does, it introduces us to Mr. Caliban, who's in Logan, and he's a little different in Apocalypse, so I guess it's like his intro. I guess Apocalypse talking to him, and he just smacks him away. I don't know, but he's a cool character in Apocalypse and in Logan, but I think he's way better than Logan, honestly, no shit, but, I mean, you know, it's nice to see him in this one, I mean.
Alright, I like Apocalypse, but everything in Logan is better, literally everything.
Logan's the best movie, we're not gonna get into that, but,
yeah.
I mean, Logan is just a movie that doesn't even feel like an X-Men movie, it just feels like an amazing movie, like, it doesn't even feel like an X-Men movie.
It just feels like an amazing movie.
Just, like, you can watch it and never seen a single one. That's just how great it is.
You probably could, yeah. That is a good
point. That's what Brian, he never saw any X-Men movies until Logan, and he loved it. It's just incredible. But anyway, talk about Apocalypse, so. So yeah, Oscar Isaac, I think he did a pretty great job. Maybe some people don't like him as Apocalypse, but I thought he did a pretty great job. I mean, just like I think Tom Hardy did a pretty great job as Bane, you know? I think they did great, you know? Yeah. Maybe they're not as good as, like, you know, I don't know. They're not as good as the middle movies. Obviously, Days of Future Past and Dark Knight are the best of these trilogies.
Apocalypse, the villain, the reason why I don't love him is not, it's not as extreme, but it's for the same kind of reason why I don't like Steppenwolf from Justice League.
Okay, Steppenwolf is a different story.
I think Apocalypse is a really cool design, but they're both kind of like this mythical grand villain that's going to end the world, and it's just something I've seen.
So okay, here's the thing Apocalypse has over Steppenwolf, though, the excellent quotable lines. No more weapons! No more!
Everything they've built will fall, and from the ashes of their world will
he's a better villain, definitely, because everything, every little thing in X-Men Apocalypse is better than Justice League.
Well, no shit, but...
Yeah, Justice League, but...
Well, hopefully the Snyder Cut's better. I'm hoping it's better. So, what else happened in the movie? So, oh, Apocalypse, when he goes and meets all of his, like, four horsemen, and he, like, touches them, and he, like, transforms them. I always liked that part of the movie. I was like, ooh, it was, like, so cool. Yeah.
I kind of forgot about that, if I'm being honest. Something really stood out to me. It was kind of just like, oh, that's cool.
Well, the final fight's amazing, too, where all the X-Men team up, use their powers, and then Jean leashes her Phoenix Force, and then, like, Storm shocks him with lightning, and it's just really epic and cool.
The final battle is the scene where Charles fights Apocalypse in his mind.
Well, yeah, that part, yeah, but...
together scene.
Every X-Men uses their powers together to take him down. It's pretty dope.
Yeah.
My only gripe with that final scene is I wish Wolverine also came in to help. That would have been, like, really cool, because...
You know, yeah. Actually, okay, the one scene I don't love in Apocalypse, or, I mean, there's a lot of scenes I don't love, but, like, I'm not sure how keen I am on the Wolverine scene.
Yeah, when I rewatched that part, I'm like, is this needed? Like, I don't know.
Actually, this is what I realized when I first watched it, was I thought, this is just begging to be rated R. It really wants to be rated R.
Maybe that's why they made Logan rated R, because they realized, hey, this would actually work.
Logan is wouldn't be as amazing.
Yeah, no shit. If it was PG-13, nobody would love it as much. But
yeah, I remember complaining. I was like, oh, I want Logan to be PG-13 when it came out, and now I'm like, no, you didn't. It would have.
Are you kidding me? Yeah.
Back then, I was 12.
Bruh. Okay, I'm not talking about Logan. I'm gonna talk about that later. But
yeah, it's still X-Men.
Yeah, it is an X-Men movie, but it's very much its own thing, you know? Anyway, so, I think X-Men Apocalypse is great because it's very much an X-Men movie. Like, it's not focused on Charles and Wolverine so much. It's definitely focused more on the X-Men members, which I think was pretty cool, you know? We didn't get a lot of that in the other movies, but...
I think with people comparing this to Days of Future Past, I do think it's unfair.
Well, no shit, Days of Future Past is way better. Is that a fair comparison? Like, no.
I think with it is that Days of Future Past is such a creative and well-produced, well-put-together movie, and then Apocalypse is just a really fun movie.
Yeah.
And
I think people just wanted another Days of Future Past, and they're just like, oh, it's not as good, so it sucks.
It's not that. What I would say is I think Apocalypse, it's I do enjoy it, but I think it could have been better. I think it could have been amazing.
Yeah, it could have been better had Wolverine came in, fought with Apocalypse, and...
Actually, no, it could have been better if they just made some of the plot points more creative to me. Because the more I've been thinking about it during this...
What, more Apocalypse?
A lot The movie Apocalypse, yeah. There's a lot of plot points I just don't remember. Or I remember them, but I wasn't thinking about them.
Well, another thing is Jubilee should have been in it more. She only had, like, one cameo. I'm like, bruh, yeah. She's in the freaking TV show!
Also, I know she had a problem with it or something, but what's her name? A girl who plays Mystique.
Oh, Jennifer Lawrence, yeah.
Yeah, her whole complaints about, oh, it's the costume's uncomfortable. That annoys me, because when I see her, when I think of Mystique, I think of the blue, red-haired person. I don't think of this just normal chick. I want to see, like, Mystique.
Well, they gotta market the movie with Jennifer Lawrence. That was the idea.
Yeah, I know. I think it's annoying. I think it should have been changed, but okay.
What else? Shit. What was? Okay, also the explanation of, I guess, how, like, the Apocalypse came back from being asleep. I guess the sun shone on the pyramid and he woke up. But I don't know. They should have explained that part a little better. I mean, well, he's just asleep and he wakes up.
That one plot point, and that's that whole thing, is the exact reason
why. They should have explained certain things like that better. I don't know.
Black Adam little ad they released for Black Adam, right?
I really hope Black Adam is explained better, because the way they explained Apocalypse coming back is just kind of funny.
When I saw that ad, I thought, whoa, it's the almost identical backstory of Apocalypse. Apocalypse's backstory, if you really think about it, is very basic. There are so many movies where it's like, the villain's this ancient being that's mystical and, like, so powerful.
Okay, but Black Adam would destroy freaking Apocalypse. It's not even a fight. Also, Dwayne The Rock Johnson is playing freaking Black Adam. Come on, man.
Okay. If you compare, I don't hate Apocalypse, the villain, but, like, Thanos, I know it's not nice to compare Infinity War and Endgame to this, but Thanos is, like, Apocalypse, but just better.
Well, no shit, he's Thanos. Like, what the hell?
Yeah, I know, but, like, they could have done that with this villain.
Maybe. I like Apocalypse as a villain in the comics, too, but, like...
I don't dislike him. I mean, I'm just, like... I like it when the movie develops, lets me have at least a tiny emotional understanding of them. To me, Apocalypse is completely understandable, a god being talks in mythological grand ways all the time. And really, all I can think is, oh, they gotta stop him. And I never have any emotional connection to his ideas or anything.
Well,
versus Thanos,
who you get
really attached to.
Yeah.
In the way the movie wants you to. So.
Well, some people complain about Endgame, like, well, it's not the same Thanos. And I'm like, whatever.
Yeah, shut up. Because he still has the same personality, same effects and everything. And also, that's not the point of the movie. So shut up.
Well, whatever. I still love Endgame, but...
What do you want them to do then?
I like how Endgame worked, because it's like, it made Thor's and everybody's story a lot more enriching when they had to fight past Thanos, you know what I mean? I don't know.
Yeah.
That's back just me,
Apocalypse,
but...
though.
Yeah, back to Apocalypse, so...
Okay, here's a question. Do you like the fact that they brought Bryan Singer back?
Oh, hell yeah. He did great on both this and Days of Future Past, I mean...
His X-Men and X2 are arguably two of the best in the whole series, but definitely X2.
I'm not a big fan of the first one, honestly, even though it's good, but I still don't think it's that great.
It's kind of cheesy, but I like it. X2's great, though.
Yeah.
Days of Future Past is basically perfect.
Alright, guys, here's my... I love X-Men Apocalypse. I actually like it more than First Class and X2.
Controversial opinion, but I will take it. I don't agree, but I'll take it.
I know, people are like, Tate, what the frick? I just really love the fights in the story. It's really cool. I don't know. I'm sorry.
It's kind of one of those movies that I'm like, I know it's not amazing, and I know it's not great, but it's a lot of fun, so I don't care.
Also, I mean, it like shows how he got bald. I mean, it's just so much story in this movie. It's like really cool.
I think it's funny that they decided they needed an explanation for a man to go bald, as if that just doesn't happen over time with certain men. Like, no, we need to give an origin story to his bald head. Like, how about he just got old?
Well,
how did Sir Patrick Stewart get bald? I definitely don't think a mythical godlike being made him bald.
I think another reason Apocalypse didn't do so well is because Deadpool was such a huge deal that year that I guess people didn't care about X-Men Apocalypse as much.
I mean, it did. It made profit. More than guess. Dark Phoenix.
Well, no, shit, Dark Phoenix is like the biggest flop of all time.
It's one of the biggest superhero bombs ever, and I think it deserved it, but okay.
Well, first, they didn't even title it X-Men Dark Phoenix. That was their first mistake. And second off, it was a bad, really not that great of a movie, so.
I have Dark Phoenix holds up on my... I have the Wikipedia. I want to see how much this movie made again, because I forgot.
Yeah, I didn't do... I saw it in the theater, but it was pretty empty.
$250
million. I think Apocalypse, in this movie, he's kind of just that villain that's just there to threaten the heroes. He doesn't have a lot of development or... character like Thanos does, so that
I mean is it out of the picture for me to expect a lot of development in all the characters including the big villain when that's what Days of Future Past did perfectly?
But Days of Future Past didn't really have a villain though, just the Sentinels. That was the
but they were able to develop every character to the extent they needed to be, so there's not really there isn't really a villain, but they definitely had the ability to now make an Apocalypse.
Well, technically, Magneto's the best villain, but if you count him as a villain.
Yeah, I guess he is kind of the villain in Days of Future Past, which they didn't really have to do much development there because he already had development.
I mean, also Trask in X2 is pretty good villain, honestly. Like,
They've had some really great villains.
Honestly, Apocalypse to me is just the most enjoyable just because of his grand speeches and his powers. I mean,
endlessly enjoyable.
Yeah.
It's not like, a lot of them to me are like, there's something more than just the fun to me. For me, Apocalypse is just fun. And
ironically, my favorite movies in this series are the ones without villains. Days of Future Past, Logan, and Deadpool 2 don't really have villains. I mean, they're just antagonists in them, really.
You're right, Deadpool 2 doesn't have a... I never thought about that, actually.
The best ones are the ones without a real villain. It's just funny. Yeah. I don't know.
Who's the best villain in all the series?
That's up to Apocalypse besides, in this one's
besides
good.
Magneto, besides
well, it's Magneto, but, I don't know. For me, it's Apocalypse, not counting Magneto, because he's just enjoyable, but, you know.
Francis from Deadpool?
I mean, yeah, but he's kind of a fodder villain. He's just, Deadpool just kills him, but, I don't know.
Here, let me explain something. I think Apocalypse and Francis are both kind of developed to the same length.
Yeah.
Basically none. But the difference between them is...
How about Dark Phoenix? Dark Phoenix, great villain, right, guys?
Yeah, it was great.
I'm a kill mystery!
That was a very useful plot. They definitely needed to kill off...
Let's talk about Dark Phoenix later. This isn't the Dark Phoenix review.
Comparing the villains of Apocalypse and Deadpool... The thing with Apocalypse versus that is that Deadpool isn't really meant to be taken that seriously of a movie.
Yeah.
It's a lot more...
Well, neither of them are, but... I mean...
And also, the entire focus of the movie is very much more on Deadpool the person.
Yeah.
Not his conflict or anything. With Apocalypse, the movie's literally named it.
I don't know. I think my gripes with Apocalypse are just that it should have been longer and developed Apocalypse a little more. That's the two issues, really.
I just think the movie could use a little bit more. I think there is an emotional side that's underappreciated, but it could use just a little bit more in that area.
Also, Quicksilver and Magneto, they were cool together, but I feel like they should have more moments together. I mean, that's just, I don't know.
Yeah.
Also, they never explain what happened with the Days of Future Past ending scene in this. Like, okay, Mystique's Trask, but then Trask just shows up in this movie and has Wolverine. Like, what?
that doesn't make any sense.
Explain, guys! What's going on? Like, I don't know.
Explain your dang movie.
I mean, if you're gonna end Days of Future Past at least explain that part.
We all kind of agree that X-Men has a really horrible timeline in it.
Well, no shit. Even Deadpool makes a joke about that. Patrick or Stewart, these timelines are so confusing.
Oh, yeah. I remember that. So, the first X-Men, X2, and The Last Stand, and X-Men Origins Wolverine didn't happen, right?
Origins Wolverine definitely didn't happen.
Yeah,
I like to pretend that didn't happen.
The Wolverine movie still happened.
Yeah. Honestly, the... According, I don't know, Logan is a very confusing movie in itself, because it's kind of like, is it acknowledging both timelines? Are they both one timeline? I don't know.
I just decided when watching Logan just to be like, you know what, forget the rest of the X-Men.
Yeah, that's what I say, just forget the rest.
It stands on its own, which yeah, I really. Think it's meant to do.
It's really just meant to stand as its own, I mean.
Yeah.
But it does reference the older movies, I mean.
I did just look and found that on X-Men Apocalypse, it has the exact same screenwriter and story by the guy who did it on Dark Phoenix.
Well, Simon Kinberg directed Dark Phoenix.
Yeah, yeah, Simon. So clearly he forgot how to write. Although then again, they were making Dark Phoenix almost as an apology for The Last Stand.
Which was a fail.
The same writer as The Last Stand.
I like Last Stand, okay? I don't know if many people hate it.
I dislike it. I dislike Dark Phoenix. I don't think that's well handled at all.
Look, I mean, they should have just not done the Dark Phoenix storyline at all, but bottom line, they should have just not tried.
They didn't know how to, and they just messed it up. And then they gave us another chance, and they somehow did it even worse.
I don't know, like, Dark Phoenix is just a hard thing to do in a movie.
It's a great way to end off the X-Men.
Well, hopefully New Mutants is a better ending. I'm hoping that's a better ending, but we'll see.
Judging by reviews, it's probably ranges from bad to okay. So
I mean, I'll take an okay X-Men movie than in a Dark Phoenix.
I don't think it's really gonna be it. I think New Mutants kind of acts like a Logan where it stands on its own.
Well, yeah, Deadpool too.
I really don't see any of the other characters in it or anything. We'll be like Wolverine.
You know what's cool when I rewatch Logan though? It's like, Wolverine's like, there are no New Mutants in it. I'm like, well, now there is, Logan.
There's a whole movie named that, so jinx yourself.
It's like, you didn't see that coming, did you?
Oh, man.
That's funny.
I remember seeing that trailer in 2017.
Yeah, it got pushed back a lot. Was it worth the wait? Probably not.
It kind of shot itself in the foot. Releasing it, I don't think. Releasing it the way they
did. I'm still going to review it, guys. That'll be the last video of this series. But
it's thus far made $30 million.
Damn.
That was probably going to be its opening weekend if it was released normally.
Epic fail.
Yeah, but also, yeah, actually, if it was released normally, it probably would have still been a bomb, because
I think Sophie Turner did really good in Apocalypse. She wasn't as good in Dark Phoenix. Well, she was alright, but I feel like Jean and her in Apocalypse is pretty good.
Great cast.
Yeah. It's not the cast fault for Dark Phoenix, really. It's just the filmmakers. I don't know.
Actually, I mean, I think a cast isn't a bad cast. I just don't think they do very well.
Yeah, we're not. Well, back to Apocalypse. So, did we cover everything? I mean, we talked about Angel. Let me think. I wish Deadpool had a cameo. That would have been cool. Like, he just says, "Hey guys," Apocalypse just blows him. That would have been funny. Yeah. Well,
I think we kind of covered everything we can say on it.
Yeah,
in my opinion, it's fun, but it's very enjoyable, not boring, but it isn't great. It's not the best in the series.
Well, I mean, it's not a First Class or a Days of Future Past or a Logan, but, you know, it's good, you know?
Yeah. It's not as good as those, but it's still fun.
Actually, I like it a little more than First Class, but I think First Class is better in the writing standpoint, but Apocalypse is better in the action standpoint, so, I mean.
I would highly recommend people who didn't enjoy Apocalypse to just give it a second viewing. I promise you will enjoy it.
Well, it's more enjoyable, especially if you've seen all the ones before it. It means a lot more to me now.
Yeah, that is a good point, yeah.
Just seeing all the X-Men unite and, like, you know, fight Apocalypse just was really awesome. Yeah. I mean, especially and when Charles gets together with his girlfriend again. Now, unfortunately, Apocalypse and Days of Future Past happiness aren't short-lived because Logan comes right after that.
Yeah.
Oh, now they're all dead. Whoops. Logan's like, well, fuck, I'm sorry, I couldn't save them, they're dead. Oh.
We kind of said everything we want to say.
Oh, hold on. I just want to say one thing. What is it? I'm learning. He touches the TV. I don't know. I think Apocalypse had a lot of great quotes in this movie. Maybe not as good as, like, what other quotes are there in this series? Shit, I can't even think of any right now. Oh, and then Magneto kills Shaw. He's like, I'm gonna move the coin.
Oh, yeah.
That's my favorite scene in First Class.
Yeah, that coin thing. That's really, really well done.
Yeah, Matthew Vaughn killed that scene. That's like the best scene of the movie.
Yeah.
I don't know. Bryan Singer's a great director. It's hard to say. I don't know. Matthew Vaughn and him are both the best X-Men. Well, not counting James Mangold and Logan, but.
Yeah. I guess James Mangold, yeah, one's the best. But also, Days of Future Past and X two are two of the best, so.
James Mangold directed the Wolverine, the first Wolverine movie.
Yeah.
But he didn't write it. That's why it's not as good as Logan, but.
Logan's technically Wolverine 3, though.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely the. It's kind of like Captain America Civil War.
Yeah, kind of, where it's like, technically, yeah, that's the third, but not really.
Civil War does kind of end Captain America's.
Logan, canonically, chronologically, is the last movie. I mean, it's the last in the timeline, so therefore it's the last movie.
It can't not be, because every X-Men dies in it.
Yeah, it takes place in the future, so therefore it's the last movie. I don't know. I mean, what is it? I don't know. I think we've pretty much talked everything. We've pretty much covered everything Apocalypse. I mean, that's it.
Should we give, like, ratings for it?
My rating for X-Men Apocalypse is a 9.4. What about you, Mark?
That's actually higher than I thought it would be. I thought it would be, like, an 8.
I love it.
I'm settling for a 7, which means in good.
That's not too bad.
Good, but I have enough flaws with it to not be, like, a great.
I gave Dark Phoenix a 7 the first time. It's going to be a lot lower the second time. I'll probably give it a 6 or a 5 the second time. I don't like it as much anymore, but.
I've only given one X-Men movie a solid 10, which is Logan.
No, I can't reveal the rating for that yet, guys. That's the next review.
I gave these.
I didn't give Logan a 10, but it's damn near close to one. Say that. I rewatched Logan. I was tempted to give it a 10, but I'm like, no, I just can't do it. Do it. It's close. No, we can't do it.
Should we do like an outro?
What's an outro? Like,
I don't know. No, I mean like, bye. I don't know.
Oh, I'm an angel. Dark Blizzard power. Dark Phoenix, yeah.